Right, let's look at this amazing feature called filtering in Excel, also known as auto filter. So here I have just a data set that I want to work with. Have a look around and see if you can find this exercise file so that you can download it. There will be a link somewhere that you can come grab it, okay? If you want to follow along, that is. Okay, so first things first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump around this data to make sure that I can kind of see how big the data is and make sure there's no empty blank rows inside of the data as well. Because if you have empty blank rows, that can cause a problem when you go to filter. Excel will stop at the first empty blank row and it will not include anything past it in the filtered data. And you'll see that there is a link somewhere to my blog on reasons why your filter isn't working. Really good to check it out, okay? Go and have a look. Okay. So I'm just going to do a Control A to select the data, and then I'm just going to use Control Full Stop to jump around the edges of my data to make sure that there are no empty rows, and there aren't. It's a good idea just to make sure that we've got everything selected prior to popping our filter on. Once we've got that, we can just go to the Data tab, go up here, click onto Filter, and we will apply these drop-down arrows at the top of each of the columns. Now each column is looked at by Excel and identified as holding numbers or values, dates or text. And depending on which column or which content each column has, you'll see different options when it comes to filtering. If we start over here with our dates, you're going to see that Excel gives us 2025-2024, and it's pretty straightforward. It's collapse and expand. I can here come into here and expand out the information. If I was only wanting to see maybe January's information for 2025, you remove the select all here and you click onto the option that you want down here. Clicking onto OK, and you will see that you've now applied a filter over the table. The data's still there. You haven't lost anything. It's still there. It's just you've got a subset of the data. Over to the side here, these blue numbers are showing you that you have a filter on. This over here is showing you've got a filter on. And at the top of the column, you're going to see a little filter icon, which tells you that you've got a filter on. And it'll also show you what the filter is. So the criteria that's actually on it. Down the very bottom here, I'm just taking my mouse right down the bottom here, and hopefully you can see where I'm pointing. 317 records were found that meet that criteria out of the nearly 2,500, okay? Excellent. Now you can keep on drilling down. So we've done it on the date. Let's come over here and have a look. If we are looking at a column that's got text in it, we can come in here and we can easily just do exactly what I showed you before, remove the select all, click onto the option that you do want. And there's only two options in there. I'll show you what it looks like when you've got more. Click onto OK. And now we're only looking at outstanding. Down the very bottom here, now you can see it's only looking at 152 records that meet that criteria. If I come over to customer name and click onto here, you can see we've got a few more options, and sometimes the options are so long that you will have a scroll bar to go and find what you're looking for, and that can be quite tedious. Everything is selected or shown in alphabetical order. So Excel goes down the column, looks for one instance of every different customer, and then just brings the name back in alphabetical order. So if I came in here, maybe I was looking for top. You can use the search box. Brilliant. So if you've got a really big list of information, use the search box to find what you're looking for. It will quickly go through and find anything that contains the search criteria you've typed in. You can see I've got quick stop shop and top shop. And of course, I can just select the one that I do want. And there we go. Now we're looking at 19 records. So I think you're kind of getting it, right? It's really cool. Now I'm going to come over to the side here. When you have got numbers, it's a different story. So if I come into here and I'm just going to click onto the drop down arrow on sales value. Now, when you're in here, yes, you can go in and remove the select all and click onto the numbers that you're wanting. But really, that's normally when it's a part number or a purchase order number or an invoice number or something like that. Yes, you can use your search as well if you want to. But if you're talking about amounts, then use the number filter. These are custom filters, absolutely brilliant. And if you come over here, you kind of use use your greater than, less than or equal to, that kind of thing. So if I came in here and wanted to go greater than, I can say I want anything that's greater than $500. When I pop that in, click onto OK, I'm now drilling right down out of that 2,500 records to find only the records that I want. And remember, if you wanted to, you can go back and just check. Okay, well, that's anything over 500 over here. It's only for Topshop and it's only for Outstanding and so on. So you can easily go and have a look at what you've got. Now, at any time, you can highlight the information that you've filtered and just copy and paste it elsewhere. You can paste it into a Word document, Excel document, into Outlook, wherever you want. So you can easily do that as well once you've found the data. It's phenomenal, really good. If you want your data back again, there's two ways you can do it. You can back. So you can go to individual columns and you can clear. So you can clear that, but you'll see that the other filters remain. Or on the data tab, you can do this from the home tab as well if you want. You'll see there's an option here for filtering. You can clear. So you can do it here. They're the same button, just different places. Click on to clear and that will then clear all of your filters off and you get all of your data back again. If you found this tip super helpful, check out the link below and sign up to my weekly tips.